and gentlemen, welcome to the main event. Let's get ready to rumble!
Welcome to the Eastwood Collegiate Athletic Banquet. I'm looking forward to this evening of awards and fun memories of the seasons we participated in. Thanks for joining us online tonight. Feel free to chat as the night goes on, and remember, this is a school event. This past year has been another successful one for our athletes at Eastwood, and tonight, just sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Fall Team Awards.
Hello everyone, I'm here to present the awards for Junior Girls Basketball. The Junior Girls Basketball team was back in action this year after having a few years off. We had a pretty successful season, and we won our first round playoff game. The first award is the Coaches Award. The nominees are Olivia, Rihanna, and Nayakir. All of these nominees are very deserving of the award, but we decided to choose the one who was a good teammate all the time, and went above and beyond the coach's expectations over and over again. The winner of this year's Coaches Award for Junior Girls Basketball is Nayakir Reith. Congratulations. The second award is the Most Valuable Player Award. The nominees are Tash, Olivia, and Elisa. One of these three young ladies led us in scoring almost every game. She was very good at attacking the rim and could also shoot from the outside. She was a leader on our team, and the most valuable player is Tash Farquharson. Congratulations, Tash.
Hi, this is Miss Uniat, and I am presenting the award for cross country this year. We have one award this year, and that goes to our most valuable player. Our nominees for this award are Connor Gerber, Justine Vogan, and Nathan Paul. All of our nominees made tremendous effort. They beat their personal bests, and each of them placed first in their respective races, out of the students on the team. The winner for MVP this year goes to Nathan Paul. Nathan got first place in several races this season. He participated in all of the races. He qualified for OFSA for the second year in a row. This year at OFSA, it was very cold and icy and slippery and snowy, and he completed his 5-kilometer race in 19 minutes, placing 7th place. Fantastic job, Nathan Paul. Well deserved. Congratulations, and we'll see you next season.
The junior boys volleyball team had another awesome season where we were able to develop on and off the court. We had a great core of grade 10 players who acted as mentors for our grade 9 players throughout the season. Each of the members of our team improved throughout the season. We were able to better our serves, shut down offensive attacks with blocks, and scramble on defense to surprise top teams in the league. This year, our coach's award goes to Derek Martin. Derek always came to practice on time and ready to learn and develop his skills. Both on and off the court, Derek was always receptive to feedback about his play. He was always ready to compete whenever he found himself in the game. Congratulations, Derek. Our team MVP for this season is Keyshawn Alexander. Keyshawn was a key member of our team, both on and off the court. He helped to anchor our play by being able to finish an attack or dive or sprint across the court in order to defend. Keyshawn was able to secure points in pivotal moments within many games. In addition to his play, Keyshawn was respected by all of the players on our team. Congratulations to all of the junior boys volleyball players. I can't wait to get back in the gym next year and challenge all the rest of the schools within WRDSB. Go Rebels.
Hi, Rebels. Coaching volleyball is truly a thrill this year. Some of the highlights included being in Preston, last year's champion, 3-0, winning back-to-back-to-back games to put us into a winning record, and securing our first Eastwood playoff game in over a decade. Special shout-out goes to Coach Maracha, who kept things fun and light all season long, and yet brought fierce competitive nature. On to our award winners. Coach's Choice nominees include Josh Oakes, Philip Gramos, and Dietrich Riegel. Winning the award is Dietrich. Dietrich was always the first one to be setting up, taking down, and doing whatever his coaches asked of him. Sometimes he had to play setter, right side, left side, the occasional middle. Each time he would answer the call with a simple, "Yes, coach," and go about doing the best he could. Our MVP nominees were Julian Eichhardt, Dietrich Riegel, and Ryan Hackbert. Winning the award was Ryan, our clear MVP. Ryan led the team in kills, digs, blocks, passes, and fewest words spoken. Ryan had an attitude of never quit, and when it mattered most, when the games were on the line, that's when Ryan would elevate his game the most, helping inspire his teammates around him and propelling us towards a winning season. It was truly a thrill this season. I look forward to coaching again next year. Goodbye, Rebels.
The first award for the field hockey team is the Rookie of the Year Award. Our nominees include Bianca Harris, Riley Heimbecker, Safia Lala, and Elena Riegel. Now, what can I say about our rookies? Bianca, she was a wall of a goalie and always full of energy. Riley was a hustler, never gave up on the field. Safia was a character, but she had a natural athleticism that no one can deny. And Elena Riegel always dug down deep, never gave up. And the winner is Elena Riegel. Congratulations, Elena. The second award for the field hockey team is the Coach's Award. Nominees include Ashley Boyce, Michaela Hunt, Rebecca Braun, and Sadia Nassimi. Now, Ashley was always high-spirited, always pumping up the girls. Michaela has a great attitude and is an all-around great team player. Rebecca was a quiet leader and a dedicated team member. And Sadia was just a positive light, always trying, never giving up. And our winners for the Coaches Award are Michaela and Rebecca. Congratulations, ladies. The final award for the field hockey team is for our MVP. Nominees include Rowan Bissonette, Brooke Evans, and Emily Wallner. Rowan was a speed demon, always going full tilt, and her energy motivated the team. Brooke, a skilled player, a team leader, and showed strong leadership skills. Emily, quiet but highly skilled, and she was noticed by coaches around the board. And the winner of MVP is Emily Wallner. Congratulations, Emily. Now, the final award for the field hockey team is the self-awarded Most Hilarious Coach Award. And the winner is Miss Dale.
Winter Team Award.
Hey, Rebel Athletes, Ski Team Coach Watson here, speaking on behalf of myself and the awesome Coach Singh. The 2020 Alpine Racing Team consists of Kylie, Megan, Blythe, Emily, Hugh, Ethan, Trevor, and Ross, and they had a fun ski season this year. We had excellent weather, lots of snow, and no cancellations. During the season, our girls' team won bronze at WCSA and one individual gold medal, and Ross won the bronze medal at both WCSA and Kuwasa. The moral of the story is, if you ski, join the Alpine Ski Team next year. The first award is the Girls Alpine Racing Team's MVP Award. This award is earned by a member who demonstrates downhill racing skills, takes initiative, is a team player, helps others, is enthusiastic, dedicated, and communicates well. These are important virtues because we have long ski days and we race in freezing weather with over 150 other skiers. The nominees for this award are Emily Woolner, Megan Gerber, Blythe Watson, and Kylie McCracken. These fine girls attended ski training and were committed to the team while fulfilling their academic commitments at ECI. The girls' MVP goes to a skier who was new to our team this year and has never raced before. This personable skier proved herself to be a valuable teammate and brave Alpine racer. This rebel racer won individual gold at WCSA and also led the Level 1 girls team to win the bronze medal at WCSA. The winner of the MVP award is Emily Woolner. The next award is the Alpine Racing Coaches Award. This award goes to an experienced Alpine racer who readily shares their racing skills with his or her teammates and shares ski drills, race course inspection, and tips with teammates. The nominees for this award are Ross McKellar and Kylie McCracken. Both Ross and Kylie proved to be valuable role models and leaders because of their former experience in Alpine racing. The winner of this year's Coaches Award is Kylie McCracken. Next is the Boys Alpine Racing Team MVP Award. The nominees for this award are Trevor Kleinekink, Ross McKellar, Hugh Watson, and Ethan Kleinekink. These fine racers competed at WCSA and Kuwasa. They attended ski training and were committed to the team while fulfilling their academic commitments at ECI. Each one of them is passionate about skiing and racing. This year's MVP Award goes to a skier who was new on our team. This personable skier proved himself to be a valuable teammate and role model. This rebel racer went on to win bronze medals at both WCSA and Kuwasa competitions. The winner of this year's Boys Alpine Racing Team MVP Award is Ross McKellar. Please join Coach Singh and myself in congratulating our winners. Go Rebels!
Hello everyone, I'm going to be presenting the awards for the curling team. The first award is the Coaches Award, and the nominees are Alex Robinson, Kaylee Millinger-Schneider, and Dietrich Riegel. What can I say about the nominees? Well, Alex truly cared about everyone on the team and would always check in to see how they were doing. Dietrich had this positive energy and would suggest ways that the team could improve. And Kaylee would make sure that the team was well organized and would find fun ways to increase our team spirit. And the Coaches Award goes to Dietrich. Congratulations, Dietrich. The second award is for the Boys MVP Award. The nominees are Aaron Pfister, Dietrich Riegel, and Alex Robinson. Aaron always displayed great skill and determination. Alex had excellent good game strategy, and Dietrich had strong leadership and was highly skilled. The MVP Award goes to Dietrich. Congratulations, Dietrich. The third award is for the Girls MVP Award. Nominees are Kaylee Millinger-Schneider, Michaela Hunt, and Madeline McNeil. Madeline had many skillful shots. Michaela had good game strategy, and Kaylee had strong leadership skills and lots of energy. The MVP Award goes to Kaylee. Congratulations, Kaylee, and congratulations to all the winners.
Hi Rebels, I miss you guys very, very much. Welcome to your virtual athletic banquet. I'm Mr. Parkinson and I wish I could be joined by Mr. Maracha, but he is somewhere else, social distancing. The junior boys basketball team had an inconsistent year. We struggled all years with injuries and people missing games for various other reasons. Because we hardly ever fielded an entire team, we ended up finishing 10th in the league. But we were a tough team to play, being close in every game, including against the top seed WCI. At the end of the year, when we finally had our entire team healthy and able to play, we won our final three regular season games and won an upset playoff game. We eventually fell to the tallest team in the league, Huron Heights, in the playoffs. We were really short, but no one could match our speed and defensive pressure. In the end, despite a rocky start, it was a pleasure to coach these boys and see them grow. It was awesome coaching with Mr. Maracha, whose knowledge of the game and connection with the boys was awesome as well. Our Coach's Award is given to a player who demonstrates a commitment to the team, exemplary behavior on and off the court, punctuality, attendance, and respect from teammates. The nominees this year are Logan Henderson, Camden Allen, and Keyshawn Alexander. This year, our winner is the one with the coolest head, the one who is selfless, the one who made everyone else around him better, Keyshawn Alexander. Congratulations, Keyshawn. Our MVP nominees are Keyshawn Alexander, Dew Simon, and Abrima Nayabali. Keyshawn's presence was most felt when he wasn't on the court. He did all the little things well, and he was always in the right position. You didn't know how good he was until he wasn't there. As said before, he made everyone around him better. Dew Simon was a straight-up scorer, oftentimes our only legitimate threat. He could finish with his floater or hit from deep. Abrima Nayabali was one of the best on-ball defenders in the entire league, consistently shutting down the opposing team's best player. He was a pest on defense and a bulldog on offense, using his strength and speed to beat his opponents. Our winners, yes, co-MVPs this year are Abrima Nayabali and Dew Simon. Congratulations, boys. Thanks so much, and go Rebels!
The senior boys basketball team took home their third straight Wixa title and the second straight undefeated season, going to Quest and beating Guelph Centennial for the second straight year. In the finals, it was pretty sweet, with some unlikely heroes like Jacob Makins and Julian Eichler stepping up huge for the Rebels. OFSA was another great experience, and although we didn't come home with the gold that we wanted, we showed ourselves to be an excellent group of young men who show what's possible when working hard together. This year, the team was carried from our fifth years, featuring Mukhtar, I have a sore thumb, Muhammad, JJ, I don't do morning practice, Adigan, Abdulaziz, I really am 26, Jasmine, DeWeet, I really am 14, Simon, and Ladira, I don't like English class, Ujulu. Well done, team, and I'm certainly going to miss all of you. Now for some awards. The nominees for this year's Defensive Player of the Year award are Jacob Makins, Noah Nadvulu, and JJ Adigan. All three of these players played exceptional defensive roles on our teams, and they were often tasked with the thankless job of taking away the star player on the other team. Jacob did a big job for us at Kwasa and OFSA, and throughout the season, Noah was our leading rebounder, but it was JJ who put forth a solid defensive effort in every game he played, from the first game of the season to the last game of the season. And our winner of this year's defensive MVP is JJ Adigan. It's been a pleasure coaching for the last 3 years, and I look forward to whatever steps you take moving forward with basketball. Well done. The nominees for the MVP award are DeWeet Simon, JJ Adigan, and Ladira Ujulu Obeng. DeWeet and JJ both had great games first during this undefeated Wixa and Kwasa seasons. DeWeet had a game-high 17 points against SJM in the Wixa final, and JJ helped carry us at OFSA. However, the winner's no secret. After winning consecutive Wixa MVP awards, I'd like to have Ladira Ujulu join me on stage. It's been great coaching you this past year. Would you mind telling me one of your highlights from the season? Was it OFSA?
Yeah, that's right.
Or Sarnia?
Yeah, that's right.
Did you actually think you could get away with a prank on your coaches like that?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, we don't need to go into that now, but congratulations on winning the MVP award for the second year in a row, and good luck as you weigh the options for next year. I know you're tossing around the options of scholarships to the States or attending Carleton with the pretty girls, but I know in your heart of hearts you want to come back to Eastwood for a sixth year and do another special placement that Brunswick can arrange.
Thanks for having me, Steven. You're the man.
As a coach, I could not have asked for a better group of players for this year's junior girls volleyball team. I knew we were in for a good time when at the first exhibition game, which we won, they were already making team TikToks. The girls developed as individual players and as a team and gave some big names a run for their money, including the SJM Highlander. Thanks for an awesome season, Rebels. The first award is the Most Valuable Player Award. This year's winner has demonstrated exceptional skill, passion, and leadership on and off the court. She brings everyone around her up and has been a crucial component to this year's success. The nominees for the MVP award are Mercy Adong, Lana Samardzic, and Boyla Ray. The winner of the MVP award is Lana. Congratulations. The second award is the Coaches Award. The nominees for this award are Ariana Weir, Brianna Lee, and Emma Burness. The award goes out to an extremely versatile player whose easygoing personality and willingness to learn has been a delightful addition to the team. The winner of the Coaches Award is Brianna. Congratulations, Rebels.
This year's wrestling season went very well. Many wrestlers achieved more success than they previously had, including we had 5 Wixa champions, 2 Quasa champions, and 2 Offsa bronze medalists. Way to go, Beast from the East. First Wrestling Award is the Boys MVP Award. Nominees are Omar Mahmoud, Connor Gerber, and Nathan Paul. This year's Boys MVP goes to Connor Gerber. He was Wixa champion and Quasa silver medalist. Congratulations. The next Wrestling Award is the Girls MVP Award. The nominees are Claire Agostini, Alexa Splain, Tatum Benninger, and Emma Blake. This year's winners are Claire Agostini and Emma Blake, after both won bronze at OFSA. Congratulations. The last Wrestling Award is the Coaches Award. The nominees are Oscar Wise, Madison Green, Jacelyn Collins, and Alexa Splain. This year's winner is Alexa Splain, who in her first time ever wrestling became Wixa and Quasa champion and placed top 12 at OFSA. Congratulations.
Hi, Eastwood.
Hi, Eastwood. Miss Paz here. And my dog and my children. Super happy to present this year's cheer award to the one and only Kelly Sames. Say hi, Kelly.
Hi, Kelly. And
say congratulations. Eastwood.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, Kelly. You are so deserving of this award. You are a definite leader, a born leader. You did a wonderful job this year, replacing me, so to speak, in my maternity leave. As you can see, my life is crazy. Thank you so much for everything you've done this year to support the girls, to support athletics. You are wonderful. Congratulations. Love you.
Hi, Rebels. Miss Hodgkinson here. I'm going to hand out the Ready Awards for this year. Ready Awards are given to senior athletes who demonstrate skill and who make a positive contribution to their respective teams. If you participate in more than one team or on more than one team, you can earn multiple Red E's in one school year. The following student athletes have all earned a Red E from their coaches. Ryan Hackbart, Josh Oakes, Dietrich Riegel, Julian Eichler, times two, volleyball and basketball, woo-woo, Brooke Evans, Ashley Boyce, Connor Gerber, Alexa Splain, sweet name by the way, Jacelyn Collins, Ladira Julu Obang, also a very cool name, JJ Adigan, Dawit Simon, and last but not least, Jacob Makins. Congratulations, Rebels, to all of you athletes who have earned a Red E for this school year. Go Rebels! Peace!
This award is in honor of a former Eastwood librarian who gave everything she had to support Eastwood athletics. We present this award every year to a parent who exemplifies these same qualities. This year's winner has done things I couldn't have even asked for or imagined for the basketball team. From driving a van full of sleepy players to tournaments all across the province, to hosting team dinners and sleepovers, including a Mexican-themed soiree over the Quasa weekend. Wayne Thompson, you are more than deserving of this year's award. Thank you for supporting not only your son Ryan, but also taking the basketball team as your family. Well done.
Major Awards.
Junior Girls Athlete of the Year Award. This year's winner played field hockey and wrestled and would have excelled at rugby once again had there been a season. There's no doubt about that. She's not one to smile a lot, but that serves her well when she's competing in the sports that she plays. She once again won bronze at OFSA wrestling again, just like last year, which is an extremely difficult thing to do. So congratulations to Emma Blake, this year's Junior Girls Athlete of the Year winner.
Hello, it's Miss Arbeau. I'm here to present the Junior Boys Athlete of the Year Award. This award goes to a player, an athlete, who is dedicated to their sport and often plays multiple sports. The winner of this year's Athlete of the Year is Nathan Paul. First, I'm going to talk about Nathan as a person. Nathan shows his leadership. He attends practices. He's responsible, he communicates with his coaches. He is humble. He accepts his accolades with grace when he continues to win and win. He is dedicated. He wants to get better. He joins clubs outside of school so he can practice his skills. And he is resilient. I saw Nathan take a wrong turn at a race, which typically would mean you would not finish. He hung in it, got back on course, and won the race. As an athlete, he plays three seasons, track and field, wrestling, and cross country. As a track athlete, he finished top 10 in the WICSA 1500, and he finished third in the WICSA 3000. As a wrestler, Mr. Weiss said that he just kept getting better. At WICSA, he was a silver medalist, and at QASA, he was a bronze medalist. And lastly, in cross country, the sport that I am privileged to coach Nathan, he excelled the best that I have seen in my teaching career. He's possibly our best cross country runner that we've had at Eastwood. He won WICSA, he won QASA, and he went on to finish 7th place at OFSA. Think about that. He is the 7th fastest runner in this province. Nathan Paul is well deserving of this award. When you see him in the halls next year, congratulate him. Great job, Nathan.
Graduating Female Athlete of the Year. The Graduating Female Athlete of the Year Award is given to someone who's shown dedication, success, and leadership over the course of their high school career in athletics. To say that our winner is dedicated is certainly an understatement. Once she commits to something, especially a team, she is there 24/7 and the hardest worker usually. Our winner has achieved success in all the sports she's participated in. Field hockey awards, wrestling awards, rugby awards. She's done it all. However, her most impactful quality, I would say, is her leadership skills. Our winner has always let her actions speak for her, giving her teammates inspiration and someone to look up to. Congratulations to this year's graduating female athlete, Justine Vogan. It is well deserved and you will be missed.
It's my pleasure to present this year's Tom McKenzie Graduating Male Athlete of the Year Award. Generally, this award is given to a student who has consistently demonstrated good sportsmanship, significant skill, and a commitment to his teams. This year has been a very unusual situation, with many of our athletes losing out on their spring sports teams, which made our decision process a tricky one. In the end, we looked at an athlete's entire sporting career at Eastwood to determine our award winner, of which there was one recipient who stood out from the rest. This athlete has amassed 3 MVP awards and was probably on his way to a 4th. 1 MVP nomination in grade 9 and 2 nominations for a coach's award. He has also represented Eastwood as a WICSA All-Star. Please join me in congratulating this year's graduating male athlete of the year, drumroll, Josh Oakes.
Hey, little Josh. Josh, please stand up. Mrs. Oakes, make sure he stands up. Well, according to Bruinsma and Maracha, you have earned this award because you are fiercely competitive, dedicated, accountable, and a winner. I quote, "He never missed a practice and was always as hardworking in practice as he was in games. The team fed off his energy, especially when he would make the impossible digs and fly over a bench to try to save a ball. He helped take the team to its first playoff berth in over a decade. An amazing, high-character guy that was loved by his teammates and coaches." Now, on to his soccer exploits. Josh has a long history of playing soccer both in the community and at Eastwood, and I feel fortunate to have had the opportunity to coach him. I often refer to Josh as our little bulldog, fierce, aggressive, loyal, and dedicated, a master tackler, a master defender, a master playmaker, and a master trash talker. Josh, since you walked onto Montgomery Field as a grade 9, you have impressed me with your dedication, determination, and focus. So many times you were the most talented on the team, but yet you never took your playing time for granted. Missing a practice for you is not an option, as I'm pretty sure you've never missed a practice in the 4 years that I've coached you. This, in itself, is a testament to your passion for the sport and dedication to your team. You helped to bring a WICSA soccer championship to Eastwood. I will forever be grateful.
All of these qualities have not gone unnoticed, as they have earned Josh a soccer scholarship to attend St. Thomas University in New Brunswick in the fall. Congratulations, Josh, for winning the Graduating Male Athlete of the Year Award. Good luck next year. We will miss you. You know this one, Rebels. Family on three. 1, 2, 3, family.
Thank you for coming to the show tonight. This event couldn't have happened without you, the athlete, our great coaches, and our supportive admin here at Eastwood Collegiate. A special thanks to both Ms. Arbeau and Mr. Winkler for putting together the show. I look forward to returning to athletics in the future, and to those of you missing their final seasons, I'm truly sorry that you missed out on that exceptional experience. To our grads, thank you for pouring your time, hearts, and energy into making Eastwood Athletics what it is today, and I look forward to having you return as alumni in the future. Now, let's enjoy the wrap-up video. Now let's get this party started.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Wait a minute. Who are you?
Hey, yo, kid.
Let's go. Yeah, I took the cash route. I put in more time, more grind, no line. I didn't take the fast route.
Let's go.
Suck it up, no crime, no crime, no crime. I didn't ask for handouts. Yeah. Go to work, no grind, no shine, no shine. And that's how you stand out.
Yeah,
yeah, that's how I stand out.
Yeah.
Yeah, I took the cash route. I put in more time, more grind, no line. I didn't take the fast route. Suck it up, no crime, no crime, no crime. I didn't ask for handouts. Go to work, no grind, no shine, no shine.
Yeah.
And that's how you stand out. Yeah, that's how I stand out.
Let's go.
Yeah, I took the cash route. I did it. I don't even pick up a pen.
No, I'm coming straight up off the top with it.
Let's go.
I ain't a power 40, ain't a center, but he was on the block with me.
Ooh.
Shooting in the gym.
Really got it in. He put up the shots with me.
Uh-huh.
Now we breaking bread. Everybody playing. He hold up a knot with me.
No cap.
We took the cash route.
Let's go.
Yeah, I'm talking moolah, fatty.
Uh-huh.
We grew up off of noodles, spaghetti. Used to be peanut butter and jelly.
Uh-huh.
Now the chef, he gon' come when he's ready.
Uh-huh.
What you know about the lights off candles?
Lights.
I pop out with the mic off dance.
Like Mike.
I'm a star on the moonwalk. Now I got the whole room talking. Yeah, I'm talking trophies. Everybody talking down, acting like they know me. I'm a champion, like LeBron.
Ballin' with my homies.
I'm better than the old me. R.I.P. to Kobe. Yeah. Yeah, I took the cash route.
Uh-huh.
No more time, no grind, no line. I didn't take the fast route. No crime, no crime, no crime. No crime. I didn't ask for handouts. No grind, no shine, no shine. And that's how you stand out.
For war.
Ooh.